taken up to center by Tarasenko, and he loses it there. It's tipped away, and the Kings send it back down in, and it's scored! They just flipped it in, and it went by Brodeur and hopped up over him.
Let's be fair to Martin Brodeur here. King dumps in. Watch how high this bounces. Oh. It goes right. That's a water bottle goal.
Robidas to Dillon. Brendan Dillon with a wrist shot that went off Leonard Petrell and somehow bounces into the net.
Sorry, it wasn't Robidas. It was Dillon. And he's going to get credit for the goal. So his second career goal here as this one goes off the back wall, off the back of Devin Dubnyk, who can't find it off the glass.
He's smart about it, though. There's a time to just get it out, and there's a time to go for the net.
Sellout crowd, 19,092, 67th consecutive sellout, and they score! It's driven in from center ice.
A big-time slap shot that hits the stanchion that holds the glass in between. Ben Bishop wanted to start coming out.
Mueller has an assist on the Phoenix goal, and of course, Setaguchi has scored the goal for the puck.
Oh,
that puck almost goes in, it's still
rolling,
and it does go in. Oh, my goodness. And is that going to be number 500 for Jeremy Roenick?
Roenick goes down the right side. He's looking, he's waiting, and then he dumps it in. And he gets a gratuitous bounce right here off the skate.
Oh, he missed it with his stick.
And in the net.
Orloff into the flow. Orloff, beautiful move to the forehand, and Pickard makes the save. Denying. It's loose. Orloff still there. He scores! Now you see him. Now you don't.
How about this move by Orly going outside, faking the shot through his legs. Now everybody thinks he has the puck, and the goalie thinks he has it. The referee doesn't blow the whistle. He says, I'll just get it and fire it.
Kessler, who threw that across, was standing still.
And that could have been defended differently a couple of different ways, but he's...
Oh, they got another one from center. It was flipped high in the air, and it went into the net.
Look at this. Right out of the crowd, there's no way that Kiprusoff even sees Mason Raymond flip it.
Going all the way down, and Louis DeMingle playing it behind the net. Boy, Louis, stay in your net. Turnover. Goal. His mask came off.
And I don't know how they take this away from the LA Kings.
Now that's a goal. He took his helmet off. I'm not really sure why.
I'm sure one of the straps had come off, and the LA Kings, they could smell it. They sniffed that out.
Net empty. Given across now to Eller. His shot is directed, but in!
Well, Patrick Hornquist deflects this puck. Letang's looking for it.
Pat Dwyer, in control, Eric Staal. Staal centers one, in the skates of Brendan Dillon. Staal gets to it, Riles with a shot blocked. Going off Sevier, they score! A little pinball wizard somehow. It finds its way in, and Carolina will take that.
What I can't tell you is Kari Lehtinen could not find it. It hit the back of Eric Staal, way up in the air. Infield fly rule, not in effect.
No team, they just have to try to shore it up here on home ice, and a turnover right to the front. And a stop that time as the net goes flying, and Clayton Keller a little bit slow to get up.
Oh, let's hope he's okay.
He should be okay on this one, don't you think, Nasher?
To be honest, I really don't know what they're looking at. Clayton Keller slides clearly accidentally into the net. Puck doesn't cross the line, so I really don't know what this could be.
Here's Kyle Raymond.
After review, it was determined that the puck would have went into the net before Keller knocks the net off. Therefore, we have a good goal.
McIntyre had designs on smearing Carlson, so Neil got in his way before he got there. Puck is dumped in. Here's Neil off the boards quickly to the front of the net. Bouncing puck hops up in the air. Scores! Off Ballard and in. He's gloved it into his own net.
Watch as he brings his glove down. He goes to bat it, and he actually reverse bats it right behind him.
On the power play tonight, 0 for 1 with no shots. Now the Kings with a chance to tie it up.
Whoa! And it deflected off of Quick into the net.
Oh, my God. The crowd is stunned. The benches are stunned. You see him lose it, then blocker, and when he lost his stick, he decided, I'm going to go after
him. To handle the puck. It's kind of scary, isn't it? A lot of people stop breathing on the Ducks bench. Set him.
His right hand, and he dropped it.
and it hit a stick, carried back through the legs, and you can see his reaction.
They did nothing with the clock. Koivu wins the draw. Ellis hustles to the bench as Perry brings it into the Nashville zone. Throws a bouncing puck. It's in! A bouncing puck, I think, again, another own goal.
Corey Perry just lofts it. Watch Suter. Hacky sack. Right off the crossbar and into the net.
Zetterberg, Cronwall off the stick of Stoll.
Up high.
Oh, boy.
It's in the net. But wait a minute. This puck, I think.
Boy, there's going to be a dispute about this one.
There's the block by Stoll.
Watch puck the puck, top of the screen.
Oh, yeah, way up there. Way, way up there. And hits him right in the back and goes in the net, if you can imagine that.
Remember when San Jose scored in here, was it?
Yeah.
5 years ago or so, down to our right?
They didn't catch
off of Roussel into the wild zone. He chases after it. Gandela bounces off of him.
Oh! And it's in the net!
Now the official right away is waving no goal.
Oh, this is going to be interesting. The net gets shoved back. Here's a great look from the overhead.
Oh, it goes over top. It is not in yet. And now it's in.
But then look at where the net is.
Yeah.
That would be the first part of it. I don't think we've ever seen this.
No.
I think it was off a skate and behind the net.
After video review, it was confirmed that the puck legally entered the net. We have a good goal.
Misplayed it. It was not touched, I believe. And as long as it's not touched, that's icing, and then it comes off the boards. It was never. He took off, bands off the glass, and off his foot, and into the net.
Phoenix, as Thornton comes to center, cuts across the line, looking against Tanev, banks it off the backboards. Hurdle there, they score! Luongo, I believe, knocked it into his own net. Joe Thornton dumped it in.
Watch this bounce. Pop off the net, off the crossbar, off the shoulder. That is the weirdest goal I've ever seen.
Blues keep it in. Steen to Oshie, back for Steen. And the puck deflects into the net. Lundqvist didn't know.
And I think it hit Steen and went in the net. He swats at it, it goes up in the air, and right over and lands on the back of Lundqvist.
Bard had Budaj beat, and it went right off the iron. Nikitin steps up, fakes the shot, and falls. Meantime, the Jackets score. A delayed penalty. Bull will get credit for his second of the season, I believe.
Keaton gets into that shooting lane, and look at, he just trips over himself. And then it's tipped, and it's hit with a stick. It bounces in the blue of the crease. And we'll see exactly who does get credit, but Bull should, as it went off of the defenseman's stick and into the net.
Gaining the line. He takes a shot. Rebound! He shipped it up in the air. It's right to go, Greece. Where's the puck? Is it in the net? The Sabres think it's in the net. The goaltender's in the net. The puck's going to drop right here. Hansel tries for it. It falls right in the back of his pants.
Lord.
And watch this.
Oh,
it's laying
Lord.
In his pants. And he's going to take it right there, right into the net. You can see the puck.
Trying to slalom his way. Now sent in front by Weber. Followed up. And he scores! What a bounce!
Off of the... This goes... What the... It goes off of Hudobin's head in the net. Oh, I didn't even realize that.
Well, they just simply weren't happy. And they had to find a taker for Abisher, so they found one. Certainly a big salary dump.
Oh, and it's in!
Oh, no! Words cannot describe this goal.
The old 170-foot shot.
Takes the shot, blocked by Huskins. Burrows is fresh. Knocked the puck loose to Edler. Back in for Alex Burrows. It's up in the air. Score!
Hit the stanchion and came right back. What a heads-up play by Kevin Bieksa. Nobody knows where that puck is. Off the stanchion and right back, and look at the reaction.
Tipped across in front again for Petrov by Belanger. With 72 seconds remaining in the first, the puck is just dumped in, and it goes in.
That goal is going to be replayed. He is not even over center ice yet before he dumps it. One hop. And the second off, one hopper.
How about that between the legs, little play to go around? Oh, I mean, you cannot turn it. Oh, we scored! We scored right at the faceoff. The Penguins just scored, folks.
How about that?
The goaltender doesn't even know it's in the net. Nobody does. I swear, the Penguins just scored. Oh, but watch this. Talbot wins the faceoff. He just wants to change. Eddie Olczyk has called for a change. He doesn't like the matchup. They're all changing. I don't even think Talbot's going to see his first goal go in. And Ninamäki, all of a sudden, he sees a shadow go by him on the left-hand side as he's cleaning his crease, Mike.
Well, I'm sure they have a view of that. We had like we had up there.
Waits. Those patience there. Armia forcing a turnover. Jackets get it back. Milano. Bemstrom sends a backhand wide. And it goes off Carey Price into the net. Bemstrom will get credit for it.
Bemstrom's shot, is a great look at this from our camera. Robocam behind the net, there it is. He boots it in.
And Elliott trying to make it past, cut off by Van Riemsdyk. Oh, it's off the Blues defenseman in the goal. And in Petrangelo. And it's 5-3.
Certainly since Randy Carlyle made a swap with center Iceman, there's been a little bit of change here, but this is how funny this game is. I mean, how often is that going to happen?
Puck out of a dangerous area.
The face-off! 1-0 Boston!
Well, face-offs are such a key, and even though the Bruins lose this draw, Patrice Bergeron actually breaks his stick in this draw against Plekanec. It's just a misplay by Carey Price.
But instead, it's played back on now by Backstrom onto Carlson.
Kunitz is out of gas right now.
Chance, a wide open net, and that's a freebie for John Carlson. Again, puck is around the glass, you've got to stay in your net.
A little too far for him, but Trocheck will pick up the rebound pass, he'll fire one right on, pops up on Drieger, it goes in the net, they score!
Off of Luostarinen, or right off the backside of Drieger and into the net. Off the back.
And since then, it's changed.
Grabner with a shot that was high. It went in! Off Tuukka Rask!
Take another look here as it goes up high. Back the other way. No, I'm sorry. Pardon me. He didn't touch it. It just went straight off the back.
Behind him, and Eller will shovel it back down the ice.
That's an example of where Henrik has to be more selfish and shoot that puck at the net. Now this is just bad luck. This is not Roberto Luongo's fault. It's nobody's fault. Just some bad luck right there.
Like it.
Now it's fed off the boards. Chipped in front. They score! Jonathan Marchessault left unmarked.
But watch Nick Holden. He does that on purpose through the legs of Carlson. And then it's an own goal.
The dressing room with a skate problem. Here's Clark Whining firing. And he sends it. The Lightning say it went through the net. The net rippled. And they're celebrating that was a goal.
Very quick shot as you see the slap shot right through.
Play is under review.
Oh, you could see it right through the net, Rick.
That the puck entered the goal and went through the net, and therefore we have a good goal.
Which they better take a look at that net.
Islanders have Park and Rieger up front. That's Davison on the intercept and the clear. Back on D with Meyer.
And I like that they... Oh, there's a goal! It bounces right by Toskala. Oh, you want to talk about a bad infield.
Well, it's not how they draw it up, but it is a shorthanded goal. And for the Islanders, their eighth of the year.
Rob Davison, watch this. Two hop, three hop, four, five, six, seven. And then all of a sudden, in true curling fashion, the sweeper gets there. And it bounces by. I mean, you got to put your body in front of it.
One last rush in overtime. Here's Brody. Carries in. Brody down the wing on the backhand with a shot. Deflected off the top of it. It's in. It's a goal. Calgary Flames have won the game in overtime.
That's a good goal.
That is definitely a good goal.
That's another come from behind win.
It's blocked and it leaps to the Sharks coming back the other way. Suter into the zone. Centering pass, gloved out of midair by Bergevin. How long did he have that puck in his glove? Now the puck's in the net! The puck is in the net! But the question is, how did it get there? There's Bergevin. That's where I thought he had it. Oh, he did!
He did. He threw it right in his own goal.
He threw it in his own net!
In other words, stick around. This could be a wild one here tonight in Raleigh. Cam Ordle set it up in behind the net.
Where is that puck? Did it get lodged? It might have gotten lodged in his pad.
Well, Cam Ward went back to stop that puck, and the puck was right in his skate. And Cam Ward brought the puck back to the front of the net.
The puck is caught in the goaltender's skate. His skate crosses the line completely, so we have a goal.
That is crazy.
I think with the lack of stoppages here in this second. Oh, it's lost by Phillips and into the net. My goodness. The Anaheim Ducks are the Stanley Cup champions.
But still, man on man. Kings won the draw, and a drive was picked up in front, and Smith scores! He took it off the boards and he tucked it in.
It's going to be in, Bob. They're keeping the play going. It appeared to me the puck was all the way over the line. Of course, they do use video replay, and if it is determined to be a goal, then you just put the time back on the clock.
Vlasic shoots. It's wide. Smith was celebrating. Now Smith with it again, but it's taken away by San Jose. A turn shot, and it looked like it went in, but no. Held out. It was Setoguchi. That looked like it got behind Bernier.
If that one goes in, and Smith's goes in, Smith counts. Nothing happens for the Sharks. If it goes vice versa, that puck was over the line, I believe, with Ryan Smith. So very interesting. Keep in mind, they'll go back, put the goal on the board, and all the time in between.
Thornton to Huskins, and it's shot high and wide into the corner. Picked up again. Here is Thornton. Thornton in the slot. Thornton with it. Can't get a good shot. Getting back with Jack Johnson, and he knocks Thornton down.
Cold shoulder by Jack Johnson and maintains possession of the puck, too.
Both teams at full strength now. Richardson out of the penalty box. He'd gone a long time without a whistle. Cutting in now. Mitchell scores! But it may not count. It may not count. If Smith's goal was good, none of this will count.
It went off his skate. He tries to get it stick first. Stick handle. Skate, but watch the second whack of the stick. Not there. It's right there as he follows through. The put back by the defender, and you can not see the puck there at the line. And it looks like, from where he's reaching for it right there with Lasek, it looks like that puck is completely over the line.
Oh, what a chance there for Lemieux. Now Russell back for the Blackhawks. Sends a bouncer, and he scores! Russell!
All he's trying to do here is to get off on a line chain. He dumps it in, it changes direction on Wendell.